Hello and welcome to the Brazilian MBA guest. We have here a guest every week talking about something that's on the interest of the business analysis community. And my guest today is the main expert in business analysis certifications. He has all the certifications from the IIBA. This guy is Alan Mishra. Hello, Alan. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Fabricio, for inviting me to the call. It's always a great pleasure to hear you, and I'm glad we're talking today.
Yes, the pleasure is all mine. And I have a good question for you, Alan, and I think you can help a lot of people with that. The question is, how to grow in a professional career as a BA?
Great. I think most of us start as a project business analyst in our career. Some of us learn it in the hard way, like I did. And some of my projects went completely off track. We made huge losses for the client. Those days, the learning was very hard because I remember when I started my ITBA career in 1996, hardly any book was available. So only we had Pressman, but it was so cursory about BA.
But today, it was about software engineering, wasn't there?
Yes,
it was not about business.
No. It was like a big topic talking, like just one chapter was probably there for BA. Obviously, it wasn't enough. But we learned it on the way, on the work. Today, fortunately, IIBA is there in the marketplace. There's a good amount of knowledge available. People are really looking at business analysis as a key field. And to progress oneself from a project BA to a strategic BA or to a consultant role, there's a lot of guide available today to us. So I personally always believe that learning and getting yourself certified is one of the finest things that one can do to keep oneself updated, which is what I try to do. It's almost my personal aim, goal, to get one certification a year. So that's how I have completed all 7 certifications from IIBA. I've done many more from others as well, because I always perceive it as a learning mechanism. Nothing else, because when I read a new book, new standard, I learn something new. Learning new things will keep you updated, and that's what will help you to grow up in your career. So as business analysts, we not only need to know process, which I sometimes feel many of us know pretty much 3 to 5 years in our career, we are understanding how to do business analysis. Then we need to hone our business behavioral skills, which is important because as BAs, we are interacting with quite a lot of stakeholders. And if we don't improve our behavioral skills, again, we'll get left out. Third, I always believe that we should improve our financial skills. We should improve our strategy analysis skills and also keep up with the technological changes. See, we are not technologists by design. Like we are not programmers or we are not architects, but we must understand what technology can do for business. If we don't understand that, then we are in trouble. And I believe technology today is making so many things visible. Like I started using a platform which has an AI-based review engine. Earlier, I used to write a lot of text myself, taking a lot of time. Now, the platform itself recommends saying, this is what you should be writing, Alan, based on your past experience and all that. Makes my life easy. And I think businesses will continue to use technology in a much more much deeper manner than what they have been doing in the past.
I have seen that digital transformation is not very much about creating technology. It's about using available technology to create new business. And so, as you said, as a business analyst, we must be aware of what technology offers for the business. That's very interesting.
True.
And another aspect that I wanted you to tell us a little bit more is that you mentioned it, like you didn't put in that words, but you mentioned like a career. You said that you could evolve from a project BA to a more strategic BA to a consultant role or business consultant. Do you see that is a natural ladder for a professional BA?
It is one of the ladders. I'm not saying that is the only ladder, but that's definitely an option for a BA. I've seen business analysts getting into project management, program management, account management. That's one space that you have. Two, of course, the consulting route always exists for you. That's also a very highly paying field. And your ability to make impact on your organization, on your client, is highest when you can provide right strategic direction to your company.
This impact that you say when you apply business analysis in a strategic context is just for people who are who have a role of business analyst, or if some other roles or other professionals could use business analysis as a way of learning, as you said, to grow, not in a professional career, specific as a professional business analyst, but another kind of professional that is also a business analyst by practice. What do you think about that?
In fact, sometimes I feel we have done a great disservice by making business analysis an analyst role, like a tight coupling, like as if only business analysts need business analysis skill, which is absolutely incorrect. In fact, to me, every business professional should learn business analysis the moment they spend few hours in business. I'm not saying that a programmer becomes a business analyst on day one, but if you have done programming for 10 years, I definitely believe any professional with more than 10 years of industry experience should start getting exposed to business analysis, because they have a potential to impact the business. And senior management in any organization, they should be trained on business analysis principles and practices. That's totally... I make a request to IIB as well. Like, let's not very tightly couple the skill with the role. The role is important. I have never said that the role is not important, but don't kind of make it so tight that people feel that other than business analysts, nobody needs to learn business analysis, which is not true.
Totally agree with you. I always think that business analysis is more a mindset than a role. Of course, we have the role of the business analyst who is specialized in business analysis and can help other professionals to apply that, but it's not just for them, it's for everyone. And if anyone wants to learn more about business analysis, I know you do have an organization that teach people business analysis and have a lot of content, free content, paid content, a lot of stuff. Could you tell us a little bit more about your organization?
Okay. I work with Adaptive US, which is an IIBA endorsed education provider. So far, we have been very focused on IIBA training and certification, and it will continue to be a major focus for us because that's what we started with. We are doing reasonably well in that category of business. But we also are expanding our services a little bit broader. So even if people are not looking at certification as an end game, but they want to learn business analysis fundamentals, they're going to launch a program very soon. We are considering launching a program on strategic business analysis, which is for senior management. We have launched programs on BA tools, which is not necessarily required by IIBA, but we currently train people on Jira, Balsamiq, MSVCO, Bizazi BPM, whole sort of tools. We also have a mentoring program in which we actually assist business analysts. Like if they have a work-related problem where they are not able to get help within their organization, because many small organizations may not have multiple BAs, maybe a couple of BAs, and they may not be senior enough to do their role. So we are also offering mentoring program to our students as well.
That's great. Alan, thank you very much for coming here today. It was a real pleasure to chat with you and to learn from you.
Same, Fabricio. I trust this is our beginning, and I completely believe that we can do a lot more in future as well.
I hope so. Let's work on that. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.